Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel Gems of Knowledge. So in the previous video we have studied about the chemical properties of metals. Okay, so that was the part 1 of the video and this is going to be the part 2 of those chemical properties. So if you have not watched with that video, the link will be provided in the description box. Go and check it out. So before starting the video, make sure to subscribe to my channel and also click on bell button to get the notification as soon as I post my new videos. So let's start with the video. So the fourth reaction here is reaction of metal with its solution of other metal salts. Okay, so how the reaction of metals will takes place in combination with the solutions of other metal salts. Okay, so when the solution of other metal salts are reacted with the metals, how the reaction is going to be occurred. So here the general reaction is given as follows. You can see metal A plus salt solution B. Okay, one metal A, we don't know which metal, just for example we have taken it as metal A. Okay, and the salt solution of that metal B. Only the salt solution of that metal B. When both are reacted, what we are going to get is the salt solution of A, the salt solution of this metal we are going to get, and metal B we are going to get. Here we have taken the salt solution of B, but after the reaction we are going to get the metal B. So here basically what happens is this metal A is going to react with this salt solution and it will become the salt solution of this metal. Okay, and whatever the B was left here, it is nothing but the metal B. Okay, by an example you can understand it. Fe plus CuSO4. Okay, Fe plus CuSO4. Fe is nothing but iron and here this is nothing but copper sulfate. Okay, so when this both are reacted with each other, mixed with each other, so what happens, this Fe is going to be settled with this SO4. SO4 is nothing but the salt solution of this Cu. Okay, so it is going to be settled with SO4, so we are going to get FeSO4 and this Cu will be left freely. Okay, so why this is happening? Just because Fe is highly reactive than your copper. Your copper is nothing but it is the low reactive metal, and whereas Fe is nothing but the high reactive metal. Okay, so why this is happening, we will learn in the further case now. So depending on this example only, let us quickly see an experiment. Okay, so you can see the experimental setup onto the screen. There is a test tube stand in which two test tubes have been placed. In the first one, you can see blue color solution. It is nothing but the copper sulfate solution. And in the right side, you can see the yellow color solution. It is nothing but the iron sulfate solution. So in the both solutions, you can see one iron nail they have taken and they have tied with the iron nail with a thread, and it has been placed into the blue color solution, that is nothing but copper sulfate solution. And on the other side they have taken one copper wire and they have placed into the iron sulfate solution. Okay, so here after this they have closed it with a cork. They have closed both the, they have sealed both the test tube mouth with a cork and they have been waiting it for 20 minutes. So after 20 minutes what we can see is the below one, you can see an iron nail has been changed it color into brown one. So why this case happened? It is just because whatever the iron whatever the copper sulfate solution was there, that copper sulfate, from that copper the sulfate solution SO4, whatever the SO4 ions will be there, it has been taken up by the iron, and the on the above of that iron nail it has become a layer of sulfate solution. Okay, so due to that, that iron nail has been become into the brown color. Okay, whereas in the other case you can see there is no reaction in the copper wire. The copper wire will be similar as it was in the brown color itself. It will not change its color to any of the other thing. Okay, this is because here in the case of blue, iron is just the having the highest reactivity here. Okay, as iron is having the high reactivity, what it does, the sulfate ions from the copper sulfate solution will be taken up by this iron nail. Okay, whereas in the right side you can see iron is along with its salt solution. So the copper is the least reactive than the iron. So what happens here? Copper will not displace the iron from itself because it is less reactive than the iron. Okay, so this, I hope you are cleared with this reaction here. Okay, I hope the experiment is cleared there. So the next part what we are going to study here is reactivity series. Okay, so why this experiment happened is just because of this reactivity series. So let us know how is this possible. So you can see here reactivity series, it is the list of metals arranged in the decreasing order of their reactivity. So what is reactivity series? It is nothing but the list of metals. You can see here list of metals have been given, which is arranged in the decreasing order of their reactivity. So you can see this is K. K is nothing but potassium. So yes, I hope you remembered, I asked you in my previous video which is the most reactive metal. So here is the answer to it, potassium. Obviously yes, the potassium is the highly reactive metal here. Okay, potassium, as I told you, potassium is the very very reactive metal. You can see most reactive, potassium is nothing but the most reactive metal. So after potassium it comes to sodium. So after sodium it will be calcium. So after calcium, magnesium, then aluminium, zinc, Fe is nothing but iron, then Pb is nothing but lead, then hydrogen, this is copper, Hg, this is nothing but mercury, Ag, it is nothing but silver, and Au is gold. So this gold and the silver both are the least reactive metals. Okay, so you can see decrease reactivity is decreasing like this. Okay, so here you can see Fe comes somewhere here. Okay, and next what is given here? Cu. You can see Cu is here and Fe is here. So which is the most reactive metal here? Fe is the reactive, then your Cu. Iron is more reactive than your copper. So we can say iron can displace your copper. So because of this, iron will make this copper to split this bond between itself. So this CuSO4 will be splitted up and this Fe will join to this SO4 and it will form a bonding with this SO4. Okay, so this is the only reason, because of this reactivity series and high reactive and low reactivities, this displacement reactions can be taken place. Okay, so here one note has been given, high reactive metal can displace the low reactive metal. So it means this is the high reactive metal and it can displace the low reactive metal. So which is the most reactive metal here? It is nothing but potassium here, and potassium can displace all these metals. Okay, I hope this reactivity series part is cleared with you all. So depending on this chemical properties, there are few questions which has been placed in your textbook. So let's quickly have a glance on those questions. So let's start with the question and answer section here, which is present on page number 46 of your NCERT textbook of class 10th. Okay, so the first question here is, why is sodium kept immersed in a kerosene oil? You have heard that sodium is kept into a kerosene oil and not in a water. Why? The question is asked here. Okay, and you have to answer to that question. So let's see the solution over here. Sodium react with air or oxygen so vigorously that they catch fire if kept open. So they are kept immersed into kerosene. So you all know that kerosene, when it is placed into water, it will suddenly, it can catch fire. Okay, so they are not keeping it into open air or not in water, because you know that water also contains oxygen. Okay, so we have to keep the sodium metal immersed into kerosene itself. So moving to the next question here. Second one, write the equation for the reaction of. Okay, and here questions have been asked below this. You have to write the equations for the reaction of. First one is iron with a steam. Okay, so let us see the reaction here. So this is 3Fe plus 2H2O will give Fe3O4 plus 4H2. Here 3Fe, Fe is nothing but iron. Iron is having the symbol Fe and 4H2O, that is nothing but water. Okay, steam in the sense, you know that it contains water. Okay, so we will get the answer as Fe3O4, iron oxide. Okay, so Fe3O4 we are going to get, and hydrogen gas will be released out. Okay, so one more question is asked. Calcium and potassium with water. You have to write the reaction for the equation of calcium as well as potassium. So two reactions you are going to write here. So let us see the solution. First one, Ca, that is nothing but for calcium. When Ca is added to H2O, H2O is nothing but here water, it will give a CaOH2-wise. Okay, this 2 is nothing but, it has to be the smaller one which is written below the line. Okay, so CaOH2-wise, that is nothing but calcium hydroxide plus hydrogen gas as well as heat will be liberated. So similar reaction will be given here for the potassium. Potassium is the symbol for potassium is nothing but K. So here we have taken 2K plus 2H2O will give 2KOH plus H2 plus heat. Okay, so I know you all will get the doubts for how to write this formulas. CaOH2-wise, why here 2 have come and why KOH, there is no 2 and the 2 has been written before K. So I'll be clearing this doubts in my next videos. Okay, so stay tuned and stay connected with my channel. Okay, moving to the next question. Next question is given as, you can see the image over there, that is, samples of 4 metals A, B, C and D were taken and added to following solution one by one. So here 4 samples, 4 metal samples are taken and they are being added to the following solutions which have been given there. The results obtained have been tabulated as follows. So the whatever the result they have got, they have shown us into the tabular form. So what we have to do? Use the table above to answer the following questions about metals A, B, C and D. So the first question here has been asked, that is, which is most reactive metal? So what we are going to answer here? Okay, before going to the solution, let us see what is given into that tabular column. You can see here the metals has been given. You can see here they have been given us about the metals, and here you can see iron sulfate is given, copper sulfate, zinc sulfate and silver nitrate has been given. And this reaction shows us metal A is having no reaction with iron sulfate, and but it is having the displacement reaction with copper to sulfate. Okay, similarly there is no reaction for the metal B, there is displacement reaction with iron to sulfate and there is no reaction with zinc sulfate. Okay, similarly for the metal C, there is no reaction, and at the last part there is reaction for the silver nitrate. Okay, and coming to the D metal, there is no reaction in all the 4 cases. Okay, so we can say here for iron sulfate there is displacement in case of metal B. Okay, so here the question has been asked, which is the most reactive metal? Okay, so let's move on to the solution. So for the first one, solution is here B is the most reactive metal, because you have already studied about the reactive metal series. Okay, so in that we can see among all these 4 metals which has been given here, iron 2 sulfate, copper 2 sulfate, zinc sulfate and silver nitrate, iron is having the most iron is nothing but the most reactive metal among these four. Okay, so here directly you can write the answer that here B is most reactive metal, since iron is more reactive than any other metal present here. Okay, moving to the next question, what would you observe if B is added to a solution of copper 2 sulfate? What happens if we add this metal B into the copper 2 sulfate? Okay, so let us see the solution. If B is added to copper, then the displacement reaction will take place. Okay, then moving to the third one, arrange the metal A, B, C and D in the order of decreasing reactivity. Decreasing reactivity, okay. So here the answer is, first metal will be B because displacement is present here. As you can see, displacement is given in case of iron sulfate, which is most reactive metal. Then comes metal A, for which there is displacement in copper sulfate, copper 2 sulfate. So the among the next reactivity series, after iron we'll get copper, then later on we'll get C. C is having the displacement reaction for silver nitrate, and then the last part D, because there is no reaction in all the above cases. Okay, I hope you are understanding this answer. If you are having any doubts regarding this, you can comment me down below. I'll definitely try to help you. Okay, so let's move to the next question. Fourth one, which gas is produced when dilute HCl is added to reactive metal? Okay, so you have to answer, which is the gas produced when dilute HCl is added to the reactive metal. HCl is nothing but it is a name of an acid, that is hydrochloric acid. I'm sure you are aware of this acid also. Okay, so let's see the solution for this. Hydrogen gas is produced. So which is the gas produced was asked. So here the answer is, hydrogen gas is produced when dilute HCl is added to a reactive metal. Okay, so the next question here is, write the chemical reaction when iron react with dilute H2SO4. So H2SO4 is nothing but it is also a type of acid called as sulfuric acid. So you have to write the chemical reaction with iron when it reacts with this sulfuric acid. Okay, so Fe here nothing but the Fe here is nothing but your iron, and H2SO4 is nothing but sulfuric acid. When these both react together, they are going to give you nothing but FeSO4 plus H2 will be released. Only you have to note that here Fe is joined with this SO4 ions, and this H plus will be released out. Okay, so this is the reaction. So the next question you can see here is, what would you observe when zinc is added to a solution of iron 2 sulfate? Okay, what would you observe when zinc is added to the solution of iron sulfate? If you add zinc to the solution of iron sulfate, what can we observe? Okay, so the answer is, zinc will displace iron from iron 2 sulfate. Okay, so let's see the reaction over here. Write the chemical reaction that takes place. Okay, so for the above question, we have to write the chemical reaction. So you can see the reaction will be as like this. So this Zn will combine with this SO4, and this Fe will be left free outside. Fe is in the sense nothing but it is known as iron. Okay, this Zn will mix up with SO4 and form zinc sulfate solution, and iron will be left free. Okay, so that's all for today. If you like my video, do hit the like button and also hit the subscribe button if you are new to my channel. And if you are having any doubts regarding this, please comment me down below. I'll be back soon with another topic, so stay tuned and stay connected. Thank you.